आज का दिवस कितना महत्वपूर्ण है, क्योंकि आज के ही दिवस सन 1949 में भारत का संविधान निर्मित हुआ था और तब से हर वर्ष हम इसे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे के रूप में मनाते आ रहे हैं और इस पर मंत्रालय की तरफ से शपथ ग्रहण के लिए भी निर्देश हुआ है। तो मैं शपथ ग्रहण पढ़ता हूँ और आप उसका सहयोग करेंगे, साथ देंगे। हम भारत के लोग
भारत को एक
संपूर्ण प्रभुत्व संपन्न
समाजवादी
पंथ निरपेक्ष
लोकतंत्रात्मक
गणराज्य बनाने के लिए
तथा उसके
समस्त नागरिकों को
सामाजिक
आर्थिक
और राजनैतिक
न्याय
विचार
अभिव्यक्ति
विश्वास
धर्म
और
उपासना की
स्वतंत्रता
प्रतिष्ठा
और
अवसर की समता
प्राप्त कराने के लिए
तथा उन सब में
व्यक्ति की गरिमा
और राष्ट्र की एकता
और अखंडता
सुनिश्चित करने वाली
बंधुता
बढ़ाने के लिए
दृढ़ संकल्प होकर
अपनी इस संविधान सभा
में
आज तारीख
26 नवंबर
1949 ईस्वी मिति मार्ग शीर्ष
शुक्ला सप्तमी
संवत 2000 छह विक्रमी को एतद् द्वारा इस संविधान को अंगीकृत
अधिनियमित
और आत्मार्पित
करते हैं।
जय हिंद।
धन्यवाद।
इस दिवस से संबंधित एक व्याख्यान कार्यक्रम है और आप सबसे अपेक्षा करते हैं, करता हूं कि आप सब इसमें शरीक हों और इसे आगे बढ़ाएं। इस विश्वविद्यालय के ग्रंथालयागार में अपने बीच महामना की बगिया से पधारी राजनीति शास्त्र की विशारद विदुषी प्रोफेसर अंजू शरण उपाध्याय जी का पूरे विश्वविद्यालय परिवार की तरफ से स्वागत करता हूँ, अभिनंदन करता हूँ। यहाँ हमारे समक्ष संविधान की एक प्रति उपलब्ध है, उस पर माननीय मुख्य अतिथि जी के साथ माल्यार्पण कार्यक्रम कराते हुए इस कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाएं। साथ ही एक और भी अनुरोध है कि जिनके महनीय प्रयासों से हमें यह सुअवसर प्राप्त हुआ है उनके स्मृति में दीप प्रज्वलन कर कार्यक्रम को और आभा प्रदान करें। अब मैं अपने बीच शब्द विद्या संकाय के डीन प्रोफेसर धर्मदत्त चतुर्वेदी जी से अनुरोध करता हूँ कि वो माननीय मुख्य अतिथि जी को खतक देकर उनका सम्मान करें और कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाएं। पहली बार हमारे संस्थान में संभवतः माननीय मुख्य अतिथि जी पधारी हैं, उन्हें यह बताना चाहूँगा कि यह जिसे हम खतक संबोधित कर रहे हैं यह हमारे यहाँ की सबसे पवित्र भेंट मानी जाती है। जैसे और संस्थानों में हम लोग माला फूल इत्यादि का प्रयोग करते हैं तो उसी तरह यहाँ हम लोग इसका प्रयोग करते हैं। तो ज़्यादा बातें न कहते हुए, चूँकि वो विषय की निष्णात विद्वान हैं, मैं उन्हें आप सबकी तरफ से आमंत्रित करता हूँ कि वो आए और आज के अपने इस प्रकरण पर ethos and imperatives of institution of India, constitution of India, पर प्रकाश डाले माननीय प्रोफेसर अंजु शरण उपाध्याय जी, स्वागत है आपका.
First of all, I would like to congratulate each one of us on this very auspicious day of the 69th birth anniversary of our Constitution of India that we all gathered together to celebrate. So this presentation that I have been requested to make this afternoon basically relates to where we are in terms of the Constitution implementation and the progresses that the Constitution, or the promises that the Constitution made in the past, were fulfilled. But before that, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the Institute of Tibetan Studies, to the registrar of this university, whom we know from his time in BHU, to the dean, Professor Umesh Chandra Singhji, of course, to the director or the vice chancellor, thanks to the chairperson, and all the revered scholars sitting here. Actually, when I see such sages sitting in the audience, I feel very humbled that what is it that I would like to impart to them. So in the spirit of sharing my understanding about what the Constitution is, with the hope of learning in the process, I would like to make these suggestions. I'm so very happy to know that some of our own students are here, and also some of the old acquaintances are here. The Institute is not very new to me. I have served here in many committees earlier. I have also been associated with the tradition of Buddhism and also the issues concerning Tibet. One of my students actually did her PhD on the right to self-determination and the issue of Tibetan autonomy. But thank you very much for reintroducing me to the Khata. Taking you back to the making of the Constitution, as I said, it was one of the most august tasks that... Is it all right? Is my... You know, is the language okay? Is the speed fine? Am I loud enough for everybody to understand? So, as I would like to, you know, privilege this position, saying that this was one of the most august tasks that the people of India undertook. And as Professor Singh said, that this task was accomplished with a lot of enthusiasm, with a lot of commitment, with a lot of sincerity, and it took so many years and days and months and hours to bring it to a fruition. But what is most significant about this Constitution, to my mind, is that it was framed at a time when not all was well in the Indian subcontinent. The partition was underway. Not only that, but there were issues of communal harmony, of identifying what is the tradition of India, of seeing how representative is this august body that is promising to give these almost entire subcontinent a frame of rule, a frame of laws that is supposed to take our generations into from darkness into light. I'm so very happy that I could come when the oath was being undertaken. And I was very happy to read the preamble of the Indian Constitution. The oath that most of us took outside was nothing. Was nothing but basically a reaffirmation in the faith that the makers of the Constitution of India bestowed, the makers of the Constitution of India expressed. And that faith was, and I will repeat, because that was done in Hindi, and this I will do in English, because some of us might not be very comfortable with either languages. So I've been directed to kind of insert Hindi in the English, although Hindi is my mother tongue. But for decades, and Professor Singh knows, it's been almost the fifth decade of my teaching at BHU, the language in which we have advanced our academic understanding has not been Hindi that much as it has been English, which is probably a global affair. So pardon me if I kind of keep drifting back to the language, which is not my mother tongue, which is neither mine nor your language, I guess, with the exception of a couple of people sitting behind. So what exactly was the constitution, the preamble of the Indian constitution, and what was the basic purpose of the constitution? And here I would like to say that the preamble of the constitution reaffirmed that we are going to make a sovereign democratic republic, jisme aage chalke secular term joda gaya, justice, liberty, equality, fraternity. Ye tamam jo cheeze thi, all these, you know, promises that are made, and if you read the preamble, you will find they are written in capital letters. The term justice is written in capital letter, liberty, equality, fraternity. Ye jo charo shabd hain, besides of course sovereign democratic republic ko bhi capitals mein likha gaya hai, aur we the people of India ko bhi capitals mein likha gaya hai. To jo calligraphy ki thi Raizada sahab ne bina koi paise liye hue, wo us calligraphy mein ye directive tha ki aap in shabdon ko capitals mein likhein. This speaks volumes of the fact how important they were for us when we were giving this constitution to us. So thank you very much for listening to this, and I hope that somewhere this evening we could also kind of take this message home, that whatever little we can do towards making this promise, this assurance that the Constitution of India tried to give to ourselves, in even if it is in a very small measure, our task of being a citizen of this country and of the world, we have talked about Vasudhaiv Kutumbakam, would probably be fulfilled. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Dhanyavaad.